Good morning once again from the Abraham C. Home as we worship together with Lakefield United and Young's Point United Churches and also our greater church. Today's a day of celebration for Young's Point United Church as they celebrate 142 years as a congregation. Happy birthday, Young's Point. Happy anniversary, Young's Point. We're going to start today's service with a fun and celebratory piece on this second Sunday after Pentecost. The piece is called Come, O Holy Spirit. And we ask the Holy Spirit to come. Holy Spirit, we need you now to set the church on fire with the love of God. Your Spirit needs to be felt within our divided world right now. I pray that you set your church, us, our spirits, on fire to share your love for every single person on this earth equally throughout our families, our communities, our countries, and our world. Amen. Come, O Holy Spirit. Thank you. Our next piece is called I, the Lord of Sea and Sky. I think that this song is a good reminder that God has heard his people crying. His hand will save the deepest of sin. He will make the darkness of the world and of our hearts bright with his light. I, the Lord of sea and sky, I have heard my people cry. Yes, it is. It's every single one of us. The Lord has given this wonderful world and all that we could possibly want or need. He's called us to love one another, to help one another, to live in peace, to respect one another, and to share Christ's love throughout this world. Yes, it is I, and you, and you, and you. It's all of us. He will lead each of us. Are you willing to go and do his work and spread that love and peace? 1 John chapter 4, verse 7 says, "Beloved, let us love one another, for love is from God, and whoever loves has been born of God and knows God." Are we showing love? True love? To everyone? God's love. We have some pretty major issues in this world that have actually been going on for generations and generations. Hate and division and war have overtaken this world, and we, as God's people, are called to make peace. Genesis chapter 1, verse 27 says, "So God created man in his own image. In the image of God, he created him. Male and female, he created them." All of them. In his image. Folks, we're one race. God created one race and only one race. The human race. And we are all created by God and in God's image. Every one of us. Our world has created the division between people based on differences that we see here on earth. Those differences have somehow divided us over time and have created fear and hatred and war and sin. God calls us to be as Christ. Ephesians chapter 2, verses 14 to 18. "For he himself is our peace, who has made us both one and has broken down in his flesh the dividing wall of hostility, by abolishing the law of commandments expressed in ordinances, that he might create in himself one new human in place of the two, so making peace, and might reconcile us both to God in one body through the cross, thereby killing the hostility. And he came and preached peace to you who were far off, and peace to those who were near. For through him we both have access in one spirit to the Father." As Christ's followers, we're called to be peacemakers, to love one another as God loves us. I pray that we can be a light to the world that is seeing so much darkness right now. Let's be the light.
Our next hymn is called "Jesus, You Have Come to the Lakeshore." As you sing along with the words of this hymn, think about the words you're singing. God does not discriminate. He loves us all. He wants us all. He has chosen us all. He has spoken to us each by name, and he asks us to follow humbly. God needs our hands full of caring and constant love that keeps on loving.
Thank you.
This piece today is dedicated to our church family and friends at Young's Point United Church, who are celebrating their 142nd anniversary this week. There have been 142 years of prayer warriors and Christ's lamp carriers congregating together under the title of Young's Point United Church. May the Lord continue to bless this congregation for years to come. We thank you for your service as disciples of Christ. God's word is our light. God's light has guided this congregation for many years. And their light has guided those who have entered into relationship with one another through God. God will always guide us. And even though our own lights may feel dim at times, God's light is always there to guide us till the end as he walks beside us at all times. Even in times like we are living in today, sometimes we just need to turn and see him there.
We'd like to dedicate this next piece to Vince's uncle Eugene Cruz. who will soon be out of his palliative care bed and resting in the arms of his Savior and Lord. Uncle Eugene has always been a good and faithful servant, and his rewards in heaven will surely be immense. May this peace especially bless Uncle Eugene and all of the Cruz family, but also all of us who need to be reminded that our precious Lord always has his hand reaching out to us. Grab onto it. He is our strength when we feel we have nothing more to give and when we feel that we can do no more. Precious Lord, take my hand. Piece for today, I just want to share something that I saw on social media. 2020, the first half of 2020 anyway, has been pretty rough between viruses and horrible racism and you name it. It's been rough. People said they just want to forget about 2020, cancel it. 23-year-old Leslie Dwight wrote a poem that has pretty much gone viral on social media, and I'd like to share that with you right now. What if 2020 isn't canceled? What if 2020 is the year we've been waiting for? A year so uncomfortable, so painful, so scary, so raw, that it finally forces us to grow. A year that screams so loud, finally awaking us from our ignorant slumber. A year we finally accept the need for change. Declare change. Work for change. Become the change. A year we finally bond together instead of pushing each other further apart. She's 23 years old. Let's be the change. We thank you for joining us once again. in our worship together. Go out into the world with God's light and love and peace in your hearts. Be a change. Spread that love to all you meet, in all that you say, in all that you do. May we, through Christ's love, be a beacon of hope for this world, creating bonds where there is division, showing love where there is hatred, showing peace where there is war and unrest. Amen.